Hello, welcome. In the last two videos, we proved our first two laws of logarithms. We proved that the log base a of a times b equals the sum of the log base a of a and log base a of b. But when we're dividing two things and finding a quotient, it equals the difference of log base a of a and log base a of b. So there's this nice symmetry there. And our third law, which we'll prove in this video, third law is our clog law, that's what I call it. And the clog law basically says if you've got the log base a of a to the power c, that equals c times the log base a of a. And I call it clog because the word clog is right here, but it's really c times the log base a of a. So let's prove this one. And that really sets us up for all of our basic laws of logarithms. So let's give this one a shot. And again, with any proof, there are many versions of proofs. I'll just show you one here that I happen to like. All right, so it's funny, you know, I've done this proof many times, and I often think to myself, wait, what do I do? What's my start? Often in proving, just keep in mind that you've got to do something. You've got to try something. So here, excuse me, let's say I have log base a of a. Well, log base a of a. That has got to equal some value. Let's call it u. All right, so I know that I can rewrite things using definitions of logs here. So this is a u, by the way, sorry. If I rewrite that as an exponent, it's a to the u, little a to the u, excuse me, equals big A. Is that helpful? I have no idea. Well, let's just try something else. I see that I've got a to the power of u equals big A, and I see there's a big A right here, so maybe I can substitute. In other words, if I have log base a of a to the power of c, well, since a has to equal a to the power of u, this has to equal log base a of a to the power of u, and then that is being raised to the c power. Right here, there's a c. I can add another set of parentheses here to kind of encapsulate what I've just done. I've just rewritten a, but it looks a little bit messy to me, so I'm going to pull those out. All right, I'm feeling good about this because now I can do more stuff, right? And often I'm kind of just flailing through a proof to see what I can do, but I know that using a law of exponents, definitions of logs, laws of exponents, I can usually make some headway. So here, with these two exponents, u and c, I just multiply them. U times c. All right, and then what does this thing equal? A to what power, saying a to some power, equals a to the power of uc. Right, look at that. These two things are equal if the exponents are equal, if this question mark does equal uc. So when I say log base a of a to the uc, that's got to equal uc. Little a to the power of uc does equal a to the power of uc. It's, right, it's literally in the statement there. But wait, are we done? Yes, because essentially, move these things around. C times u has to be equal to it. Commutative property of multiplication. And c times u, what's u equal? Oh, we defined that. Log base a of a. So times log base a of a. Boom. We've done it. We started with the log base a of a to the c, and we ended with c times the log base a of a, which is our proof right here. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed that.